Lady Gaga kisses married man on stage, and no, it is not Bradley Cooper. Hey YouTube, I'm your host Joss, welcome back to Inform Overload. We bring you the news, the deets, the tea, whatever the kids are calling it these days. Make sure you are following the IO team on Instagram, our links are all down below. And leave us some love in the comments for a chance at a shoutout in our next video. Lady Gaga has been making headlines recently for more than just her music. We still haven't forgotten about the suspected romance between her and Bradley Cooper, who recently split with his girlfriend, by the way. So you can just imagine what kind of stories fans are already creating and posting online. But the blonde bombshell has made headlines for another suspected romance, this time with her trumpet player, Brian Newman. Over the weekend, she caused a bit of a stir at her Las Vegas show when she took some of her lyrics a little too seriously. A video was posted to the Gaga Daily Twitter page where fans could see Gaga serenading her trumpet player and holding his hand. Only moments later can we see her sing the lyrics, "Darling, kiss me," at which point she leans in and locks lips with him. It didn't take long for fans to lose their minds, but not in the excited way like when you see two people kiss for the first time. People were actually outraged. They were quick to point out the fact that the musician is married to Angie Patani and that it was a disrespectful thing to do on Gaga's part. I mean, it is easy to see in the video that she is the one who obviously initiated the kiss, but at the end of the day, doesn't it take two people to kiss? He could have backed away if he felt uncomfortable or felt that it would be an issue to his marriage. Turns out he sees no problem with the kiss, and neither does his wife. His wife was actually in the audience the night and watched the whole thing happen. It was also pointed out online that Gaga is the godmother to their child, so when she says they are like family, they really are. Brian has spoken about his relationship with Gaga in the past. He told Forbes in November 2018 that he has known her since she was just making it big. He said, "One night after she made her first hit record, she came to see us in Tribeca. We ended up playing Someone to Watch Over Me together, and it was the start of a beautiful musical friendship. She's just a great musician and a great person, the godmother to my child, and a beautiful human being." A source close to them came forward after the video went viral and told Us Weekly, "There is nothing to see here. Gaga is a performer, and it was a playful, harmless part of her act. She and Brian have had an incredible friendship for years and see each other as family." Despite people confirming that it wasn't an issue for the married couple, it didn't stop fans from still disagreeing with it. Fans let out their opinions by flooding Twitter with various comments. One fan said, "Gaga, could you stop? He's married." Another user added, "I love Gaga, but it seems to me she needs to cool her panties with some other woman's guys. I don't give a shit if it is part of her act." People are only taking this kiss so seriously because of all the Bradley Cooper rumors. From the outside looking in, it could appear that she's always getting intimate with someone who is in a relationship. Some people are going as far as calling her a homewrecker. Not too long ago, Gaga was engaged to her man, Christian Carino, but rumors of the split began back in February of this year. It was later confirmed that they had called off the engagement and then called the relationship quits altogether. Because she's recently single, people are using it as an excuse to say that she is the one causing trouble in the Newman's marriage, which makes her apparently a homewrecker. Personally, I think that word is just a little bit too dramatic and a little unnecessary. I can guarantee that this little kiss didn't wreck their home. Although she faced a lot of heat from fans, some of them actually did come to her defense. One fan tweeted a response saying, "It's just a show. She knows how to work it. It's called acting. Married people kiss others all the time in movies, plays, shows, etc. Move on." It's not the first time she's been accused of homewrecking, so she has made it clear in the past that her artistry comes with a lot of acting and performing. When people kept questioning her shallow performance with Bradley Cooper at the Oscars, she responded by saying, "Yes, people saw love and that's what we wanted you to see. I'm an artist and I guess we did a good job. Fooled ya." So, what do you guys think? Are people overreacting or did she really cross the line with this cheeky little kiss? Personally, I think people need to follow Taylor Swift's new anthem, "They Need to Calm Down." I personally don't think this kiss was anything malicious, and at the end of the day, they are both adults and can do whatever they want. And I don't really get when people get in a fuss about other people's men. If his wife isn't bothered by it, I don't see why you are. That is just my opinion, but I want to hear yours. Let me know your thoughts and feelings down in the comments below. In the meantime, I'm going to end this video by responding to some comments from my last IO video, "Bella Thorne Gets Ultimate Revenge on Hacker." The Potato Librarian says, "The Bacon Gods Demand IO Do Double double person videos. Well, I'm sure we can make it happen. Who do you want to see? Wizard Place says, holy crap, she just bamboozled her way out of that. Only a true Friends fan will laugh when they hear the word bamboozled. Brian Hunt says, wait, are you Dutch? Not in the slightest. Like, I'm probably the farthest thing from Dutch. Ghost Panther says, well, I didn't like her much, but this makes me actually love her more. A lot of people have been saying that they respect her now that she did this. Alright, that is all I have for you today. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell before you go. You do not want to miss another video. If you want to keep watching more IO videos, just click the playlist right over here. I'm your host, Joss, and I will see you next time.